Good evening. My name is Marcel, and tonight I present to you the Battle of the Novas. 3 years ago, I found on eBay a Data General Nova 1210 computer, which is shown here on the left. The Data General Nova 1210 is one of the world's first 16-bit mini computers, and this particular computer weighs about 20 kilograms. And it consists of four printed circuit boards, one that contains the processor, one that contains 8K of memory times 16 bits, one board that contains a serial interface, and a second memory board here on top with another 8 kilo word of 16 bits core memory. Now, when I bought this computer, it was defective, so I made a number of repairs, and one of the things that I have to do is to create a front panel for the system, because this computer came without a front panel. So when I made this front panel, which connects through a connector to the computer right here, I made it computer controlled. So this front panel actually has a little microcontroller which connects it to a Raspberry Pi that is sitting here, and the Raspberry Pi also has a connection through a thin cable here to a current loop interface that connects to the serial port on the computer. That basically means that this Data General Nova, which normally would be controlled on a terminal, can now be controlled from my PC over there. So this is my Data General Nova. Now, I didn't really like the layout of the front panel very much, so I created a new front panel, but I didn't really want to change the old front panel because it's working fine. So I had one unused front panel sitting in my garage, where we're right now, and so I was thinking, what can I do with it? Now, this front panel contains a tiny little microcontroller, which is a Teensy3.2, which you can see on the screen here. It is an ARM processor, 32-bit ARM processor, which runs at 72 MHz, and it controls everything that's on this board. Now, I was thinking, well, maybe this computer is actually fast enough to simulate a Data General Nova. So what I did is I put some of the code from SimHV onto this microcontroller, and that allows me to act, allows it to act as if it is a Data General Nova computer. And since I have all the lights and all the switches, it can actually even look like a Data General Nova. So the idea of this demo tonight is to do a little battle of the Novas. We can compare the performance of a real Nova on the left and a simulated Nova on the right and see which one is working better. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to control the computers from a keyboard which is out of the field of view. And for instance, what I can type in this interface is a version, which will give me the version number of the code which is actually running in the front panel. So this is not the Nova that is answering, but this is the microcontroller on the front panel. And the left computer says that it's code written in 20 September 2019, which is the last time that I changed the firmware on the front panel controller. And on the right it says that it's a simulated mode Nova, which contains parts of SimHV 3.9, and which was last changed on July 14, 2020, so a couple of days ago. Now, to compare the speed of these computers, we have to have some software. And on the left computer, the software is actually in the core memory. Core memory is persistent. If you switch the computer off, its contents are not lost. So what I did is I took a basic interpreter, the original Data General Nova basic interpreter that I got from Bruce Ray, and I loaded that into the computer. Originally this would come as a 20 meter long punch tape, but nowadays it's all digital and it's uploaded from the computer over there into my Data General Nova. And to show you that there is some stuff there, I can say list 0 on my front panel, and it would show you what is in the memory in terms of instructions. Now, the right-hand Nova, the simulated Nova, does not contain core memory, so I have to save the information in another way. Now, this front panel has a small EEPROM over there, And actually what I can do is I can type into the control panel restore, which would restore the contents of the front pan of the EEPROM into the controller, and that contents is actually the basic interpreter plus the program that I worked with a little while ago. Now what you can see is that the lights are blinking, and that these are actually the addresses at which the microcontroller is writing into the virtual data journal Nova, and you can see the lights blinking, and it's almost done, and now it's done, and now the entire code is stored inside the memory of the microcontroller, and the code is exactly the same as the code that's in the data journal Nova. So if I do list 0, you'll see that we pretty much have the same contents, the same kind of instructions, although there is a little bit of data that is different between the two because they were saved in a different state. Now what I can do is I can, on both computers, I can start the basic interpreter. So I'll start on the right-hand computer, the simulated computer, and if I hit escape, you see it says start ready, which is the original prompt of this basic that was written 50 years ago, amazingly 50 years ago. So I do the same thing on the left-hand computer, on the real Nova, hit escape, and I get the same prompt. Now to show that these both computers are running the same program, I can just list the contents of the basic program on both computers. Let me do that on both sides. And you can see the program. It starts by setting I to 1. It prints then I and the square root of I. It increases I by 1. And then it goes back to the beginning of the program. So on both sides, both computers, we have the same program. And if I now run this program, you kind of expect what you're going to see. You're going to see increasing numbers and square roots being calculated for all numbers from 1 to very, very big. So I started on the left and we see it going, and also watch the front panel lights blink, and it started going on the right hand side, and you can see that the lights are blinking actually very similarly, but not totally, because on the left hand side the lights are connected to the actual address and data bus of the Nova computer. That means that you see every instruction coming by and the lights are blinking a million times per second. On the right hand side, the lights are simulated and they're actually only update once every 1000 instructions of the simulated Nova, because otherwise the speed would really be really, really slow. And we can see that the lights are blinking, and if we now look at the numbers that we see on the computer, we see actually that the simulated Nova, which has a significant overhead of controlling the lights and actually running the simulation program inside this tiny microcontroller, is quite a bit faster than the real Nova. We're about at count 800 on the left and count 1100 on the right, and you can see that the numbers that it's generating are exactly the same. So all in all, we can see that the tiny microcontroller, which you can buy for £20 in the shop, by far can outperform this big 1970 computer, which when it was new, this, in this configuration, would cost about £15,000. And that is maybe not totally surprising, because computer technology has improved significantly over the years. But what is really fun is that with all the lights and all the action that you're seeing, you kind of have a feeling what's going on inside of the heart of the computer. And I think that's something we can all learn from playing with old computers and restoring old computers. And at least I have a lot of fun with that. And I also hope that you have had fun with watching this movie. And if you are interested, there are a couple of other movies by myself on the internet. One that concerns about my work in radiation therapy as a professor in research, and the other movie about the restoration of this computer, the Nova 1210, which has my special interest, because originally this computer, or this type of computer, was the computer that controlled the first CT scanner that could make scans of the inside of a patient in the early 70s, and I thought that was really amazing. So I hope you've enjoyed this movie, And with that, I'm going to close and I thank you for your attention. Bye. Thank you.